Hey YouTube, what's up? Today I'm going to show you an electronics project that I've developed and deployed over the last year or so. It's a timekeeping system for live production that provides synchronized real-time clock as well as timer services for multiple rooms in the venue. I work for a multi-site church here in Vancouver. We have 7 services every Sunday. It's a really tight schedule, you can imagine. Things have to happen on time as pastors shuttle between campuses. But when I first started my job, there was no system in place to help with that. So I asked my integrator to see if they could quote me one, but they couldn't. And finally, I figured I'm going to have to come up with a solution myself. The system features several large format wall clocks, as well as a web front end for control. And here's a schematic of some of the key technologies used. So we've got the clocks running on ESP32 microcontrollers for hardware control. They also run an MQTT client for communication. On the back end, of course, we've got the MQTT broker as well as a node app, which serves as the link between device control and monitoring, and the user interface, which is web-based. The system retrieves a reference time via NTP off of a time server on the internet and then synchronizes all its devices to that time such that the maximum offset between any two clocks is 100 milliseconds or less. Now that can probably be improved, but given the unpredictable nature of Wi-Fi latency, it is pretty good and more than accurate for our purposes. In addition to the clock time feature, there are timer capabilities as well. We use a 7-minute automatic countdown to each of the 3 Sunday services in our main location. So at 9:08, 11:08, and 5:08, the clocks automatically start displaying a 7-minute timer, which helps the worship and tech teams ensure an on-time start of the services. We also use a sermon timer. You can see it there behind me being engaged manually. This is actually really important as our pastors shuttle between campuses and they need to fight traffic. And so a sermon that goes too long may very well mean that they won't be able to make it in time for the next one. Now behind me, you've been seeing some ways of interacting with the system. You can use the physical control panel, or you can use the website, which you can access from any browser-enabled device, whether that's a cell phone, a tablet, a computer, whatever. One more thing worth mentioning is that should you ever need to bring the time into a broadcast switcher, you can use this view, which allows you to customize the font color, the background color, stroke, and time resolution for the purposes of video keying. That's really the system in a nutshell. I will show you a little bit of its construction in a moment. There's obviously the development of a full stack of software involved, including the firmware for the clocks, the node app for the back end, and the web UI, and its functionality on the front end. But we'll skip all of that and just take a look at the actual clock making. Here I'm putting together a controller for a 4-digit clock. Here's the finished board with the ESP32 on top, and you can see its transistors and resistors and connections on the back. The handmade LED panels consist of 8 segments of 5 LEDs each, which comes to 240 LEDs and 480 soldering points for a 6-digit clock. Some people say I'm obsessed with clocks, and maybe there's something to that given my German heritage. Here I'm connecting the panels to the controller, then flashing the firmware, and the clock works. The clocks need to look half decent, so I made frames, here drilling holes into a faceplate after marking them out with Play-Doh. 244 holes for the 6-digit clock, 164 for the 4-digit version. Then the LED panels go in, and here it is. Next is the frame behind the faceplate. That gets put together, then the electronics get put in, and finally a lid comes on the back. Here's the 4-digit clock getting painted. Same process with the frame. Electronics go in, a lid comes onto the back, and the clock is ready to go. Last is the P3 matrix, which is, by the way, the most expensive component of the system, around $30, before the ESP32 was $7. The cost of all other parts is negligible when you get them on eBay from China. Anyway, there you have it. Feel free to comment or email if you have questions, and subscribe if you want to see more electronics projects. Sometime later this year, I'm planning on making a video about the larger production automation system that the clocks are part of. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.